In December 2018, a snippet of an unidentified song was posted to What's That Song by user Gabor72. With no information provided by the poster outside of the short 30-second snippet, the song has remained unknown for over 5 years now. Take a listen.
And now I know it's just a game. I don't need the rules to play. Maybe it's happy, maybe it's sad, but you can't choose the way to play. And now I know it's just a game. And I don't need the rules to play. Maybe it's happy, maybe it's sad, but you can't choose the way to play.
The search for the full song, as well as who made it and the song's name, has grown in popularity recently, with most comments on the What's That Song thread being from the last few months. There's been a range of songs which have been suggested, which have turned out to be debunked, and here is a list of them. Sadly, there doesn't seem to be many leads that can help find the song as of now. One of the first replies to the thread states the lyrics, which are easy to understand due to the decent quality of the snippet. I have a theory about the song based on the lyrics. Often a director of a commercial hires someone known as a music supervisor to choose a song to play in the background of the commercial, and the song chosen is usually instrumental or has lyrical themes relevant to the commercial. Perhaps the song was used in the background of a commercial of some kind of board game. Take this with a grain of salt though. I remember when people were suggesting that the unknown song known as I'm Yours was used as an internet safety PSA about the dangers of communicating with strangers online. However, when the full song was found, it turned out to just be a standalone song, and people were looking too far into the lyrics for answers. I'll hedge my bets on the song just being a random rock song which was recorded and posted to the internet with nobody knowing its origin. It sounds pretty good though, so I linked r/now-I-know-it's-just-a-game in the description if you have anything to help with the search. Do you know the name of this song? YouTube user Slymuck posted an unidentified song to YouTube on the 6th of July 2008. The description reads, "Recorded to cassette tape from Swedish rock radio in the days when that was the way to catch new music. According to notes on the tape sleeve, I recorded it on April 5th, 1980. For this song, we actually have the full thing, so I'll just play a section of the song. Here it is. This is honestly my favourite unknown song at the moment. Also in the description of the video, the poster includes a list of all the other songs they recorded on the tape, which could be useful for the search. Like the poster said, they recorded it from Swedish radio, so perhaps the band that made this song were also Swedish. However, it's pretty unlikely, as in the comments the original poster says, "I think it sounds pure British. Besides, I wasn't much into Swedish music at that time." Also, a lot of the other groups recorded on the tape aren't Swedish. For example, Cheap Trick, Psychedelic Furs, and Pretenders, which makes this theory less likely. I believe that this unknown song deserves way more attention, and it's probably my favourite out there right now. If you have any idea who made this song, please leave it in the comments. This song was posted onto the Spirit of Radio website way back on the 20th of March 2005 by user Marek. The poster doesn't provide any context or information behind the 30-second snippet, which sounds like this. In my opinion, the singer doesn't sound fluent in English. Some people have suggested that the singer may be Japanese or Korean, but I kind of get the feeling that they are Eastern European for some reason. This is my interpretation of what the lyrics are. Unfortunately, outside of the lyrics, there is really not much to go off which could narrow down the search. This song was posted onto the internet all the way back in 2005, which makes it one of the oldest unidentified lost songs, as Like the Wind was posted to the internet in 2007, and we still haven't gotten closer to finding the full song. It's a good sounding song though, so if you can help with the search in any way, please do. The lost song, commonly known as Uptown People, was posted to What's That Song in July of 2023, by user New York 80s Tapes. They say, "Sounds like something APB would do. 22 seconds is all I got." This is what it sounds like. I really like the snippet, and it's one of the more familiar sounding ones to me personally. It may help the search to know who the poster is. Their What's That Song profile description reads, "I have a collection of tapes from New York and New Jersey radio stations during 1980 to 1986, mostly new wave, punk, post-punk, synth pop, and space electronic. Maybe the group that made this song was local to New York or New Jersey. If the band was popular, we would probably know who made the song. This is just a theory though, and the song could be from a lesser known band from anywhere. The song, however, sounds like it could have been a big hit, and it sounds professionally made as well. The lack of lyrics for this snippet also makes it harder to find. The most likely lyrics are up on screen. This lost song is really underappreciated, and the most viewed upload of the song has around 6,000 views. If you have anything that could help narrow the search down, please leave it in the comments. This lost song, nicknamed Dance for Hours a Day, was first posted to What's That Song in July of 2007. It's a short 30-second snippet. Take a listen. Although the quality of the audio is good, the lyrics are pretty hard to decide on, but I put up what I think they are on the screen. From what I've seen, a lot of people think that the audio is from a live performance because of the crowd cheer sounds that you can hear at the start of the snippet. I don't believe this, to be honest. Sure, there are crowd cheer noises, but they cut out so quickly and perfectly when the band starts playing. I think it's just a studio recorded song where the band decided to add crowd sounds after to emulate the sound of a live show. A famous example of something like this happening is the Elton John song Benny and the Jets. The Elton John song was recorded in a studio, but during the mixing process, the engineer took sounds from Elton John's 1972 performance in Royal Festival Hall and a 1970 Jimi Hendrix concert. These sounds were then added to the background of the original song, and reverb was added to the entire mix. I believe that something similar happened for Dance for Hours a Day as well. It's also really not hard to add crowd sounds and reverb to a song to make it sound like a performance. If this is true, it narrows the search down quite a bit. In the comments of the What's That Song thread, the poster says, "I can't remember right now, but at that time I used to download from person to person, most probably torrent." This makes it harder to find the full song, as it could be anywhere on the internet. Recently, a longer sample of the song has been found, which includes more of the crowd noises heard at the start of the snippet. In my opinion, this makes it even more likely that the crowd cheer sounds were added after, and this is not a live recording. The original poster also says in the thread that, "It may be that I took the song from a film, but it's more probable that I downloaded a soundtrack compilation. Anyway, that movie didn't trigger anything for me. Over the weekend, I checked over 100 DVD backups with no luck. Almost certain that it was torrent as person to person." They also say in the thread, another hint, "I liked ska music at the time. Ska is definitely a lead." This is one of the most popular lost songs at the moment, and there have been countless vocal and instrument isolation versions of the song posted to YouTube. Do you have any idea who made this song and how to find it in full? Every song that I featured in this video was suggested by someone in the comment section, so thank you. Although I do enjoy making lost media videos, I have other videos on my channel that you might be interested in, so go check those out as well. Also, if there's any video ideas that you have outside the space of lost media, please leave it in the comments, because I want to know what kind of videos you'll want to see on my channel. As always, links are in the description for the references and music I used. If you liked the video, please leave a like and subscribe. Thank you and goodbye.